God, it is said, sends the wool, seams, when they are most needed, not men and women of general holiness, but specialized experts who fit into the pattern of times and are capable of giving God's tone to this century. And so it was that on August 16, 1815, when one era was closing in Europe with the exile of Napoleon and the Industrial Revolution was clanging another open, a man was sent by God whose name was John. Good morning, respected principal, Reverend Father Nelson, beloved teachers, and my dear friends. Today, I, Ningthim Yankong, am standing in front of you all to present a short speech on John Bosco, widely known as Don Bosco. The great saint who was born to Francis and Margaret Bosco on the hills of Bekinturil. At the age of 2, he lost his father. From a very early age, he decided that he would dedicate his life in helping young people. Johnny was ordained in June 1841 and started to work for the poor youth of Turin, who were suffering from the ill effects of industrialization and urbanization. He started teaching methods based on love rather than punishment, a method that became known as the Salesian preventive system. He was declared a saint of the Catholic Church on April the 1st, 1843, due to his works of offerings and help to the youth, morally and educationally, to cope up with the world around them. He opened technical schools, hostels, and other institutions which grew up into a big organization, namely Don Bosco Society, with 3 main branches, the fathers, the sisters, and the brothers. The great saint and an educator of youth, Don Bosco left the world at the age of 73 on 31st January 1888. The work of this humble priest has grown from tiny seed to a gigantic tree, stretching its branches across the countries and continents. With a feeling of pride of being associated with Don Bosco Silchar, I hereby conclude my speech. Thank you and have a wonderful day.